What is good, guys? We are here with more OUPL. We got TL6. I forgot who his opponent is because he's on an alt. But yeah, this is like TL brought some super wild heat. Probably Megazord Y with sun support for Shiftry, and my browser's lagging because I have so many tabs open. I didn't expect this game to happen now, so I wasn't ready to record. That's why I'm like lagging. I just saw this game started. We see Mega Heracross on the other side, which is pretty cool. I assume that Zard will have Earthquake or Focus Blast to be able to hit Heatran because we don't see a Doggy or something along those lines to get rid of Heatran. So, like, Zard will definitely have a move to hit the Heatran. You see probably Rock Swampert. I've seen a Jammet use that. In a live where I used the Teal team. And I've also used the Darius team with a Rock Spurt. I don't expect Teal to be super wild and be like Sunny Day, Shiftry and regular Zard with solar power and like Mega Swarm, but I don't expect him to be that insane. He called himself top tier boy probably because he thought, I don't know, it's just a words play. Because top tier boy just played Ricardo. That game was wild if you saw it. Yeah, check it out, I uploaded it. What is Sherry that run OUPL? Yeah, and Black Oblivion also brought one. No spoilers if you didn't see that game. That game was fire too. He brought some sun heat. But yeah, I would probably go into, if it's a Solvest Tornadus, he can go to Tornadus here. Because either the Focus Blast or the Earthquake is coming if the Zard stays in. You can also go for Toxic with Heatran if he's confident that he can live any hit. But he just decided to go into Tauron, which means he's probably a Solvest, but the Focus Blast still is an okay chunk. And the problem with Tauron is you can't really hit Zard other than with Hurricane, and Hurricane is only 50% accuracy. Unless you run Smackdown Tornadus or HP Rock, which is not really sets. That's something you would use in like League format, when you specifically know your opponent has a Zard Y and you're kind of weak to it. Oh, I assume that's gonna be a Scarf Excadrill. I see he misses a Hurricane, it's only 50% accuracy, and Fire Blast is gonna cook this. As Teal predicted him to pivot out back into Heatran. I mean, Tauron can live a hit, I assume, if it's Assault Vest. Fire Blast might kill, but it should have a Flamethrower. Oh, TDK is online. I hope TDK was a Gypsy. I hope you see that game too. Because the score is 3-3 at the moment between the Cover Kratos Manas and the BBC Kings. And yeah, if one team wins two games and they go 5-3, they win OUPL. This is finals. And if it's 4-4, I think we're gonna see tiebreaker or something along those lines. I can see Teal going for Focus Blast again, predicting a U-turn, but it's not necessary. Oh, my boy BTB is playing Teal for World Cup qualifying phase, or however you call that. He's probably playing next weekend. Or on Friday, it's not sure yet. But yeah, Hurricane misses again. I mean, it's 50% accurate. So if this is not a Z-movement journey, if it's I assume it's gonna be Scarf Lottie, so journey can still be Z-move or AV. I think this makes the most sense to be the Z-move mon, especially since he brought this in on the Tornadus. Cause Tornadus could just knock off the Assault Vest if it was Assault Vest, and it would be a bit annoying for Teal. But even if he's a V, he can go for a slow Volt Switch and grab momentum that way. Unless his opponent goes hard into Drill, which I don't think he would do here. But a Shift Game again, I could see this being HP Fire in the Sun. Because Sun Boosted blows away Ferrothorn. I mean, maybe it can also be Z Focus Blast for Heatran. So Zard doesn't have to rely on hitting Focus Blast with that. Actually, now that I think a bit about this, Dragon Dance Zygarde with Z-move is, it could be an option. So this could be AV then. Because like, he doesn't have good Greninja checks other than this. Like, Swampert doesn't takes way too much. Yeah, that's Assault Vest because it's sun boosted, and he goes for Volt Switch. So his opponent decides to get off the damage on Majuna instead of getting rid of the AV, which is understandable as this is a chlorophyll is shit free. Yeah, I think that's confirmed AV, and like I said, probably the outrage Zygarde. Could still be banded, but I think it's the outrage more than likely, and shift free can go for a knockoff here. I can also see a double switch predicting the Heracross. But he doesn't have the best double switches for Heracross. He can double into a Latios depending on the set. Like I said, I think he's Z-move Zygarde. But if he for some reason has... Oh my god, he goes for HP Fire! Okay, I thought he would double into something that beats the Heracross like Latios. Or like Zard. I didn't think he would go have HP Fire on this. That's some heat. But yeah, the sun runs out. Even if Shifri can still outspeed this, it won't be able to kill it. The Heracross is pretty free to click close combat here, because the resists that are Latios and Charizard still don't appreciate close combat at all. Oh, let me data. Data Shifri real quick. 90 special attack. I mean, I was expecting knockoff SD set with Sucker Punch. And they leaf blade, something like that. I'm pretty sure he's just gonna go for CC. He doesn't Mega Evolve in case the Shift Tree is speedy, and he can potentially outspeed the Shift Tree if it stays in. But yeah, not Mega Evolving is fine there. He can just close combat again. Pretty sure there's. Like, Teal is just sacking this Majuna. There's no point in keeping a 1% Majuna and risking the Zard or the Lati here. Like, you just don't make that play. Yeah, it's kind of sad that we will see the other Smokta series tomorrow, which will be... I mean, Porsche, I knew that Porsche would play tomorrow versus Steve. But the Alex was Bengay series, I was hoping to record that today. Because I'm not sure how much time I have tomorrow. But I'm glad that I'm able to get most of them OUPL games at least. I think... Oh yeah, I think this is Tony, by the way. Yeah, Teela's playing with this Tony. I think this is Tony Flygon. I can recheck. We check real quick. Why can I not talk? Yeah, Teal 6 was Tony. Okay, cool. Picks up the Majuna and the Zard is gonna come out, I assume. I mean, Zagat is an option because the Heracross is at -2, so... I mean, he has a lot of options, basically. These 3 mons are fine here. Zard is honestly really scary for Tony's team. If T went for Fire Blast or Flamethrower early on the Tornadus, it would have been so low. But yeah, he's either banded. And it's gonna click 1000 arrows. This is his 1000 arrows resist, like this was his only good switch into 1000 arrows. I could see max defense Ferrothorn maybe to like kind of switch into it. I mean, either the Fiend or the Pharaoh, one of the two is probably pretty fist dev. I mean, Tapu Fini is like the main one that keeps the Zagat in check, to be honest at this point. Cause if he would switch out here to Ferrothorn and Dragon Dance, Zagat could Dragon Dance again. It would be really dangerous. Especially if it's ground Z move. Like if it's ground Z move, it can break through Ferrothorn easily. It can also break through Fini potentially, yeah, if it still has the Z move intact, that is. And if it gets 2 Dragon Dances up, Scarf Drill won't be able to outspeed it, and also Scarf Drill doesn't kill it anyway. Like, we already know he's a Solvest Majorna, you know, he was. And maybe he doesn't have a Scarfa, so the Latios could still be Z-move, and maybe this is Bandit, but I'm just not 100% sure. Because, like, his speed control could be relying on Sucker Punch and on Sun Sweeper. I don't even know if he has Sucker Punch, but the Chlorophyll, basically. And he has E-Speed on this, probably, and he has a bulky backbone, so that's always cool. But I kind of struggle to analyze this team, because it's just a bit too much heat for me. But I'm glad that I didn't miss any turns, because I was like lagging for a minute at the beginning. But his opponent, like Tony, had to like look at this team for a while, because it was like... Let me scroll up for you guys, I don't know if you saw it. Let me process what I'm seeing for a bit. Oh, even, yeah, okay, Ricardo even said go Captain Tony, so this confirms it. I always get confused when people are on some... on alts. They just decide to go Pharaoh. And it's Choice Bandit and he gets a crit. So he either doesn't have a Z-move or the Z-move is on. Oh, the Z-move can be on Shift Tree, what am I saying? The Z-move can be on Shift Tree and the Zari can still be Scarf, because I think you, yeah, like you still want the Scarf, oh yeah. I didn't even think about that, so maybe it's like Black Hole Eclipse, like the Dark Pulse or something. But yeah, the Ferrothorn should be able to take another hit. Actually, it might be a roll, yeah. With a 64%, which means this Ferrothorn, I don't know if it's max defense. But yeah, it's too annoying to calculate, because the calculator doesn't have a choice band. Zygarde, it's so annoying. They only have the 10% form, not the other form, and even the 10% form, it's always at set at Jolly, so I have to change it to Element and stuff. And I don't want to miss any turns, so we'll just keep recording. As I had some nice Chinese food earlier, that was yummy. Whew. But yeah, we all know that the World Cup is taking over. OUPL is coming to an end, as he does get the potential roll. So that was lucky for Teal. The Ferrothorn could have either gotten up a Hazard or Leech Seed. And if it was Leech Seed protected, could have definitely lived another attack. After the... Like, it definitely would have been able to live 3,000 arrows. And Teal would have either switched out into Charizard. Or he had to, like, he at least had to get the Ferrothorn and get up a Leech Seed. Or get up Hazard. But yeah, this way is Zygarde still 100%. And the Ferrothorn didn't get to do anything. He's probably gonna go to Tapu Fini here. Because that's like the best check he has left for Zygarde. Tapu Fini probably, if it's Bolt. With like only, with like not max defense, with like 100 and defense Bolt, I think it still might get 2 KO'd from Choice Band Zygarde. Like I said, it's really annoying to calc, but I guess I'll do it. Zygarde, let's just say you Drain Dance, make it Element, give it a Choice Band instead of a Life Orb. And yeah, this is 192 defense Tapu Fini and takes 44 to 52. So that would be able to avoid a 2 KO, but a lot of Tapu Fini don't run that much bulk. A lot of Tapu Fini run like maybe 100 in defense. Or some run like super a lot of speed to be able to taunt other mons. Yeah, so if it's more likely to 2 KO. Okay, it only is a 30% to 2 KO after lefties. But yeah, he decided that Heracross is a fine play, that's, yeah. Because he knows now that it's locked into 1000 arrows. And he's probably gonna predict. I mean, I can calc how much a close combat does. Let's say Heracross. I'm pretty sure he's gonna Mega Evolve this time, because there's pretty much no point in. Close combat is 63 to 74. So, like, Teal can just kill this Heracross if he wants to. Southern Arrow is gonna 2 KO it. But. Okay, this is funny. Disrespect my play again and I beat your wife. Oh damn, I should have asked Pearl to call. Nah, I forgot. Obi was muted by Pearl for 1 hour. Respect your superiors. Yeah, I lost my train of thought. What was I about to say? So basically, I don't know if it's worth risking for Tony here making a risky prediction, which would be a Rock Blast or Pin Missile, because he can Oko the Zygarde and the Zygarde can 2-hit KO the Heracross. On the other side, Zygarde is so valuable for Teal, so I can definitely understand that he switched out. But I think he's just gonna go for Close Combat, but okay, he did go for Pin Missile, so he made a risky play breaking the Lardy there. But yeah, that didn't work out. Teal. Damn, I don't know if I would have risked the Zard, but it worked out. Like, what can I say? Pin Missile still did a lot. He got one crit, but still, like, every hit did like 6% or 7%. That was not a crit. The Heracross is strong as fuck. With a nice skilling ability. I feel like Heracross is for sure a bit better in Sun and Moon than in Auras. It's just so easy to bring it in. With like U-turn Tapu Koko, because you bait in Tangrowth, and like then Heracross just doesn't have good switch-ins. And it also has a pretty good bulk, it's not like it's afraid at all. I also like Healing Wish support. Should build a team with like Healing Wish Jirachi or Healing Wish. It's kind of tough. Maybe Healing Wish Clefable. There's not that many good Healing Wishers. At least I can't think of that many from the top of my head. Mansell really did it. Yeah, he didn't expect him to risk the Zard, because the Zard pretty much like puts in so much work. Like, how does he even kill the Zard? His way of killing Zard is like Tornadus getting Hurricane Confusions or dodging moves, or he doing dodging Focus Blast, and Scarf Excadrill having clean Rock Slide. But Scarf Excadrill quickening Rock Slide gives Swampert and Zygarde a free switch in, so it's like pretty tough for Tony to play around to start as he's... Oh, I thought he would Focus Blast again like a madman. He did just Fire Blast and... Oh man, I just hit my mic. I hope you didn't hear that too much. Tony can pivot into a Tarn here on the predicted Focus Blast. Oh yeah, Tony is captain of Team Europe, by the way, and Ricardo's on that team for World Cup. If I'm not mistaken, yeah. I probably just play it safe if I'm Teal, because this Heatran is annoying, and if you go for Fire Blast, you're breaking the Tornadus, and the Heatran stays in and gets up rocks for free. That would be so annoying for Teal. Like, he can either go for Toxic or Rocks here. I don't know the exact trend set, but I assume it's gonna... I mean, I know that this has rocks probably, and unless it's we didn't see yet. Oh, it could also be Scarf Charm. We don't know yet, because the Ferrothorn could technically be rocks. Yeah, the Ferrothorn. I think the Ferrothorn is spikes and Heatran is rocks, but I'm not 100% sure. Oh, also, since he has Rapid Spin Excadrill, I just realized this. The Tapu is probably not Defog. I could see a Calm Mind Tapu Fini or a Whirlpool Trap Tapu Fini to trap stuff like Toxapex. That Toxapex, I don't know, it's a bit annoying for his team, but like Heracross can break through it with an SD Rock Blast. Like, it does a lot. It doesn't Oko, I think, if it's defensive pecs, but it does a lot. Excadrill can Oko pecs, but it does super, like a lot of damage. Yeah, this game is taking forever, there's no timer, but it's completely fine with me since I'm tired and I need a little bit longer to think anyway. But yeah, basically what I meant to say is I will just click Focus Blast here if I'm Teal. But if he's a Scarf Turn and he like whips out the Ancient Power out of Stone Age, like, my lord. I mean, you can also try to make a different play, which would be going Swampert here. But he just Focus Blast. I think I would have made that play too. But I kind of got, the longer I thought about it, I kind of got shook and I was like, what if he Scarf Turn with Stone Age or Ancient Power? Like, this happens to me, like, the longer I think about a play. But yeah, he's gonna die to Fire Blast, I assume, at 61. So maybe he's gonna utilize back into Tren. Yeah, I think I just focus blasting on here from Teal. Cause like you saw earlier, Hurricane doesn't hit in the sun. It really doesn't like to connect in the sun. But yeah, so hyped if you can see TK with Gypsy King, it would be so cool. I mean, I can see Gypsy getting subbed out because he's like in Australia and they've had time zone issues before. But that would suck if he got subbed out. I really want to see him play with TDK because I think everyone knows TDK is good, but Gypsy King is not that well known on Smogon yet, and I know he's pretty good. He did win, I don't know if it was last week, but he did win versus Obliviate, if I recall correctly. And yeah, most of the other times he got subbed out, or versus Finch, he lost because of a timer. Because, like, I think he disconnected, that was pretty stupid, but you live and learn. Next time, pretty sure he will know how to reconnect. Like, he couldn't access the battle, I think, because sometimes on Smogdraws it acts weird and you, like, have to close the battle and like rejoin it from the lobby chat, and not click X on the battle that you're in at the moment and rejoin from lobby chat, not join it from the link that you're already in. But I'm 100% sure how that works, because I don't play that much on Smogdraws. I mean, like I said in one of my videos, I plan to play a little bit of Smogdraws 24, but just for fun. I assume it's gonna go Heatran here, like I said. I need to focus blast again, Teal the Lord, and we see it's a bulky Tren as it can eat it up. So this is maybe either Z-move Heatran or maybe some... Yeah, I don't think it's Z-move, I think it's like a resist berry. But the thing is, what else would be the Z-move one? If it's not Heatran or Tapu Fini, because I think the drill has to be Scarf. Dude, this team's so weak to Volcarona. Like, I was thinking that he could be HP Rock on Tornadoes, because, like, to hit Volcarona and Zard Y, because that's what I use sometimes. I know it sounds like gimmick as fuck. Smackdown or HP Rock, like, you don't even Oko Volk. Especially not have a Quiver Dance, but, like, I don't want to rely on Hurricane with my Tornadoes versus Volcarona, so I just run HP Rock sometimes. And versus that, you just saw what happened earlier. Hurricane never hits, like I said. I think he's gonna go Pert, yeah. Man, I said it too late. Now it looks... this makes me reminds me of Blunder's video. Like, when you say it too late, the people just think, uh-oh. What a genius, he says to play when it happens. But yeah, I assume that Tony's just gonna go for a knockoff here. Trying to get rid of the leftovers. You can also see Teal going back into Zard, predicting a knockoff. But he doesn't have to. I mean, Thwomped is nice to have, because I can check Extra Drill pretty well, but yeah, he's probably just gonna get up his rocks. That's also a fair play. And the Hurricane slash a U-turn is gonna come out here from the Tornadoes. I think a U-turn into Heracross is too risky. You turn into Tapu Fini, maybe predicting a Scald so you can't get burned. And it would also reveal to us if it's leftovers Tapu Fini. Because I'm still curious, what is the Z-move mon? I mean, you don't need a Z-move mon on every team. But yeah, I can prepare for some, like, this is like training for World Cup, because I'm gonna try to bring you a lot of World Cup games, and some are gonna happen at times that are not that optimal for me, which is gonna be like 2 or 3 a.m. So yeah, you already know I gotta train to stay up late, and I only get a few hours sleep a day, that's fine. I mean, I obviously won't do that every day. But like, I see that I catch the games, like, I know some people, like, because I've been recording for a while, Like, I know some people that are in World Cup, and they'll just, some of them will tell me when their team plays, hopefully. If there's not a spreadsheet, if there's a spreadsheet, that's fine too, where I can look up the times. But yeah, most of the times it's like, I don't know, I just have a good feeling when this tournament games happen. Like, I just go to Smogtours and and exactly then when I go to Smogtours, there's like a game happening. I just got that technology, I don't know how to say it in English. But you turn into, I don't see the play besides Typhophene. Heracross is a little bit risky. I could see Teal going for Earthquake though. So, if he predicts Earthquake and he goes Heracross, that's a good play if it works out. But he's probably gonna go Typhophene because he doesn't want to let anything get burned. But let's go Heracross. So if he goes for Skull, which he goes for Ice Beam. Okay, I did not think he would go for Ice Beam. I mean, Ice Beam is to hit Zygarde, so Subcoil Zygarde doesn't set up over this. We see no freeze, I think. It's a bit lagging, so I'm not sure. Yeah, no freeze, that's nice to see. So he gets the Heracross in one more time, because like Heracross only outspeeds the Swampert. It doesn't really outspeed anything else. So now that I think about it a bit longer, the play makes a lot of sense, because Swampert pretty much gets, Heracross gets revenge by everything else and only outspeeds this. So he obviously wanted to get it in there, and you can just fire off a close combat here, because I don't think Teal is gonna risk his Zard again, or his Lari. Yeah, he's not gonna risk it again. And that picks off the Swampert, which is surprising. Maybe that's Element Heracross, that's so strong, good lord. But yeah, Teal is just gonna click 1000 arrows, as there's no reason to keep this Heracross at this point. And he's just gonna sack it off. And after he sacks off his Heracross, he's probably gonna go into Typhophene. I kinda pronounce Typhophene a bit different after my BTV made some guest uploads, and he says it like Typhophene. Now how does he say it? It's hard for me. Usually I say Typhophene. My man pronounces it a bit different. And JMP said unranked for a reason, because it just got blown away and didn't do much other than getting up rocks. Did we see if it was yeah, it was the leftovers that got knocked off, yeah. And that's at max roll. I actually want to calc that real quick, because they're taking so long, and it's, to me it's pretty obvious that he's just going to sack his Heracross here. Yeah, close combat is 50 to 80, but that's not max attack. Let's put max attack. Also, we don't know that, the Swampert spread. Max attack does 54 to 63. But yeah, it's a max defense Swampert. Let's say it's only 120 in defense. Then it does 61 to 72. Yeah, it did just sack off the Heracross. Damn, so it did 73, so this was definitely not more of a Spadef Swampert. Because if I put a max, a plus defense nature and 60 in defense, then it does 65 to 77, so then it would still be a mid roll was the word I was looking for, and I said like min for some reason. Oh yeah, someone just asked in lobby if Miku can be flinched behind disguise, and I'm pretty sure it can. And TDK also said yes, yeah. My man BTV was laddering earlier with Bandit Manaphy for fun, and he flinched Mimikyu, not through disguise, but the turn after. I didn't even Oko Mimikyu Bandit Manaphy. What a weak piss meme, like, don't use that. Yeah, I don't see what his play is besides Typhophene. Unless he has HP Ice on Tornadus. But I'm pretty sure Tornadus won't be able to Oko the Zygarde, since it's a bulky Tornadus. And Zygarde's bulk is like pretty clean, like you don't mess around with that bulk. And let me actually, my boy Porsche made like a guest upload for you guys for DPP Cup Finals, and I don't think it was the best. Not because he made a bad narration, just because I talk a little bit in there too. And I don't know shit about DPP, and it was kind of embarrassing, so I didn't want to upload it. I think LL was in that a little bit too. But yeah, where's the... When did we record that game? Yeah, I'll just add that to my uploading list, because there's nothing happening. Like, my boy, like, this guy, he's taking his sweet time. But that's completely fine with me. But just relax and calm down a bit. Like, I don't have a reason to rush. Like, I find it a lot cooler when the game is like slow, and you can just think through all the options. Like for me as a viewer, sometimes I take a bit longer to realize all the potential plays. Especially in like some two games where I play super fast, I can't really follow. I still do my best. It's gonna be hard, especially at times like these. Oh, nice 4 AM, good lord. The man's showered and this is still going on. Man said, what the fuck? I mean, it's not only going on, it's still 4v4. I don't know why he didn't send out a Tapofini yet. The thing is, this is a tough position, because the Tapofini just gives the Charizard a free switch in. So yeah, this is really tough for Tony. I think Teal should win this. Just a quickly reminder for myself. Teal is on the BBC Kings, which means if Teal wins this, TDK would have to win Marissa's Gypsy King to make the score 4-4. And then I'm pretty sure we will get like some sort of tiebreaker or like some extra match or matches, probably best of three, something along those lines. Huh. This is really tough for Tony, because like Zard is such a big threat, and Zard basically kind of comes in on Tornadus. I don't want to say for free, but kind of for free, because Hurricane is only 50% in the sun. So it's like super hard to hit two Hurricanes in the sun in a row. So even if he hits one, the Zard can still roost up. But yeah, Steel doesn't even have to risk that. Like, his main way of beating Zard is probably the Rock Slide Excadrill. And Hurricane Confusion with Tornadus. Or just Tornadus hitting Hurricane and dodging Fire Blast. I think it was confirmed Fire Blast. Yeah, it was confirmed Fire Blast, Charizard. What is he running? Is he running a lot of cogs? I thought the deadline for OU Peel was like, I think they got like an extension. Like they say in this post here, please get the games done until, just get this done by sometime next Monday. And it's Sunday still in the East End, like if you calc in American time or talk, however you say that. I mean, here it's already Monday, but like, I feel like usually the deadline would be in like 2 hours from now. But I'm not 100% sure if, like, I would be super hyped if that would be the case and if we see TDK with Gypsy soon, but like it sounds in this post here, I don't think that's the case. I might just pause it until he sends out his mon, because it's really taking forever. Okay, so he finally sends out a Tapofini after like, I don't know, 1 more minute of me pausing this, or 40 seconds. If this has Defog, he can go for that, or he can go for Nature's Madness, but the Zard is pretty much free for top, I almost said top tier boy, because he's called top tier boy here, for TL 6. Oh, he was calculating shifty damage output on Excadrill. This is so dumb, why did you bring this? LMAO, what the fuck? Okay, I shouldn't have said that. Haha, poor document if he's recording. That boy knows. Shout out to NJNP. So, I don't think this is Defog, like I said. I think it's like Calm Mind. I mean, actually, yeah, if it's Calm Mind, maybe it can. The thing is, it's kind of hard, because you can't just comment up on a Bandit Zygarde. Like, if you comment up on a bandit Zygarde and he just goes for 1,000 arrows, your type of thing will just get to it KO. But if you don't calm mind, Zar just destroys you with solo beam. That's the problem. Like, maybe I should log into my main and tell him what's popping, because I'm really recording. Just not logged in at the moment. Okay, so he decides he's a speedy type of thingy, like a really speedy one. Like I said, I think Mzadwar was free there, so Teal either predicted a command or a defog. But yeah, I think he's gonna go into Zard now, because the Zygarde still has some sort of value. It can come in on Heatran, like later on. Can potentially like, I don't think it can live a Hurricane, but if the sun is up, it can. Like, try to dodge a Hurricane. Yeah, like, it still gets a kill if it comes in on the Heatran, like I said. So that's still a good reason to keep it. Like, why would you sack it? And yeah, Zard is free, like I said, and he doesn't get the special attack drop, so it's looking bleak for Tony. You can see the Heatran getting sacked here. Like, I just hit Focus Blast again here because I'm wild. I mean, he can Fire Blast. Because, like, Tony, even if he tries to pivot from Heatran on a Fire Blast into Tornadus on a Focus Blast. He still would have to take Stellar Frog on both of these mons. Oh, he can also go for Roost. Yeah, Roost is also a good play. Ruth is another option, I don't even think about that yet. I'll probably go for Ruth, yeah. Because the Zard just puts in the work, why not get your Zard that puts in work healthy? Are they in call? Because he said, are you okay? Yeah, but it would be so hype if I could see the Gypsy versus TDK him right, like, 1 hour, like, in the next minutes, like, right after this, I would be hype. Did I say I would be hype? I'm looking forward to that game, because I really think that Gypsy King is, like, has the potential to be TDK, as my computer is, about to die. Where's my charger? It's right here, but I just had some trouble to plug it in. One sec, guys. I paused it again because they were taking forever, good lord. Yeah, this is crazy. They're just not making a move. Like, I have been, like, my recording is already almost 39 minutes long. And I even paused it a few times. If I didn't pause it, it might even be like 5 or 6 minutes longer already. Man, why can I just not make a... I mean, I can understand that he's like trying to see, run some cogs, trying to see, like, he's planning out the late game. Like he said, he's running cogs, Excalibur versus Shift 3 is what he said earlier, I think. But yeah, I can just repeat myself. I don't see a reason to not click Roost, and he just go for Fire Blast and he hits. So he did predict the potential Tornado switch there on a Solar Beam. Or just... Nah, it wouldn't have covered the Heatran. Damn, I don't think I would have fire blasted there. Did I say at first I said I would focus blast and then I said I would roost? Yeah. I stand by my roost play. I would have roosted there, even though it might not be the best play. Yeah, I'll pause it until this guy sends out a Pokemon because this is taking forever. So yeah, so he played out a lot of scenarios in his head and he's like, all scenarios I play out are X. So at least we know why he's taking so long, but yeah, he still hasn't made a move. And it is really true, like I also cannot see, I don't really see how he can win, other than hexing through. But if the Shifri, damn, I'm not sure if he has a way of winning. Like, I'm not 100% sure if the Shifri has Sucker Punch. Because if Shifri doesn't have Sucker Punch, it can get unbobbed by Torn outside of the sun, like when the sun ends. Because the sun doesn't really last that long. Like, it's just 5 turns, and like Zard also has to come in again to like reset the sun. And like, until you get Shifri, and Shifri is not like not anything you bring in on a free switch. Either bring it in on a double or after you sex something. Or like, the only thing you can really bring in is on like resisted moves, and it doesn't really have any resistant moves left. Like, anything that hits is resisted. But yeah, I'll pause it again until he sets out a Pokemon, the Lord. Because he decides to go into Scarf Excadrill and threaten this with a Rock Slide. And I think I go with Zygarde or Latios here. I still want to keep this Charizard around. And he does stay in. And he gets flinched, so there we go. That's what I said, he can hex. It's not over until it's over. It's Pokemon. Yeah, I probably would have sent my Zygarde there, but maybe this was the better play until Psydon, sure. Because, like, yeah, I lost my train of thought. What was I about to say? Like, if he sex Charizard, Excadrill can spam Earthquake besides Shift resisting it. I'm still not sure if the Shift is like mixed or completely special. I just don't think I would have checked sacked Zard, because like Zard seems like it has the some value to me. Because like I would also would have roosted earlier with the Zard. Maybe it doesn't have roost. Like on the type of Fini, like why not roost? Like Zard puts in work, dude. Why not? If you have Zard super healthy, like just I think you just win if you have Zard super healthy. That also would have kind of forced him to go for Rock Slide if Zard was even healthier. But he will definitely have some reason why he didn't do it. He decides to keep it to reset the sun later on. As we will see if it's a Scarf Latios right now. Because I'm 100% sure it's a Scarf Latios. Like, it outsped the Zard. And I assume it's gonna be Timid Zard because it's running Fire Blast and there's Medichim running around in this meta and he doesn't really have switch ins for Medichim. So we wanna outspeed Adamant Medichim at least speed tie with Jolly Medichim with your Zard for sure. Because otherwise, if Medichim comes in on like a weakened Majona or Swamp, but it kinda just gets a kill. Like Majona, you just need a little bit of chip damage and you just kill it from full. Like, Medichim is crazy strong. We'll see if this also has HP Fire and is Scarfed. But that would give the Heatran a potential free switch in. I mean, he still had to hit a Fire Blast even if he didn't get flinched there. I think he hit everyone so far. He only missed a Focus Blast earlier in the Torn, which would have, maybe, how much that would have done? 15% or something? It wouldn't have done too much. I probably would go for Draco here and just try to tweet kill the Heatran. I don't think the Excadrill will stay in. Like, it's just something telling me that Excadrill won't stay in. I think I have to pause it again. I might just fall asleep because they're not making any moves. I mean, I think it's him. He's trying to figure out how he can win. Because Latios isn't scarfed and gets picked off by Ironhead here. And Zygarde comes in. I'm not sure if the Zygarde is going to be able to live Ironhead. We'll actually want to calc real quick. Where's Excadrill? Choice Scarf, Ironhead does 32 to 38. So that's a roll. He just calc 50 things and based on the Lati being scarfed, my lord. Wait, isn't this... Maybe he has some HP investment? Cause like, if it's no bulk on Zygarde, Ironhead does 32 to 38, like... It's a roll, like, highly in Tony's favor. I mean, he just goes for E-Speed to get off the chip damage, and... He has to go back into Zard now, but Zard does to Ironhead. And yeah, that flinch earlier might have just caused it? I can't really speak proper English. At 4:22 AM. I think I would have just... Like, Teal just won the game if you get the Fire Blast off. That's what I meant to say. You cannot go hard into Shift V, it's frail as fuck, it will get blown away. I mean, I could calc real quick. Excadrill versus Shift V. It might also be minus defense if it's a mixed attacker. Ironhead does 71 to 83. So Ironhead wouldn't kill. But I think the Shift V is life orb, so... If he goes hard into Shift V, he only has one life orb hit. Yeah, it's life orb. Just making sure. So yeah, Teal is gonna sack off the Zard here. Because I think that's his only play, and then... Then Tony's gonna switch out on the Shift 3 with his Excadrill. Because the sun is still up, meaning that the Shift 3 probably outspeeds the drill. And he wants to stall out the sun, but the thing is that the Shift 3 also has Sucker Punch and SD and is a mixed set and only has HP Fire as its special attack and the rest is physical, and it was just... I mean, he was probably trying to figure out the set earlier if it's like special based or like if it didn't have special attack investment because he already went for HP Fire earlier. So from that knowledge, Tony might be able to tell the set from Shift 3. Because if it's SD, it can just win with Sucker Punch if the drill switches out. But if the drill stays in, it might die. It dies to HP Fire, obviously, or... I don't know if it would die to a Dark Pulse if this is... Let's just say this is a completely special Shift 3. Let's say 252. Yeah, I just put in Lonely because that's mixed attacking. Let's just say Dark Pulse, right? How much would that do from a life orb? That would do, why did I say Dragon Bolts? I meant Dark Bolts. Get me out of here. Dark Bolts would do, 51 to 63, so I wouldn't even kill. But he did sack off the Zards. Oh, he was not Ruth on Zard, okay. Ricardo, why is your scarf a Shift 3? Yeah, I also thought he was Ruth Zard. But yeah, I assume this is like special based attacking, even though I haven't called. Okay, he's talking about. I'm assuming you brought a fast type of Fini because I love element choice Benzaiga. Let's just go for knockoff, which shows that he's mixed. For hidden power fire, just for Ferrothorn and Cesar, yeah. Cesar usually likes to switch into Shift 3. And you. Like, you, if you only have Zard that beats Cesar, that's kinda bad. So it's nice to have a secondary thing. Yeah, that's what I was saying earlier. Like, he has E-Speed and this Shift 3. So I wasn't sure which one is the Scarfer, but apparently, he just doesn't have a Scarfer. But yeah, the Tornadus might be able to live a hit. And yeah, he's just gonna heat wave because it's 90% accurate. Like, he's not gonna miss the hurricane. Ruin hurricanes, you know, he's not gonna do it. I clicked that goddamn move. Click the goddamn move. Yeah, I think the Shifri has to crit. Yeah, it doesn't kill. And Shifri has to dodge this. Yeah, okay, he just U-turns. I don't know why I said heat wave. I think I'm smoking something. I do not smoke. I don't know what's wrong with me. U-turn is obviously 4 times effective, and Shifri is frail, so that kills. And yeah, I thought Teal had this game, but it turns out he didn't have Roost on his Zara, and he got flinched, which sucked a lot. Yeah, the flinch was annoying. And now GDK has to beat a Gypsy King. No, the other way around. Gypsy King has to beat GDK. Because the score is now 3-4 for the Anti's team. And yeah, it's gonna be hard, but Gypsy can definitely do it. So we'll see if we see that game today or whenever. I know that TDK is online. I really hope I'm gonna be able to catch that live. Yeah, I hope you guys all enjoyed. I think it was... I don't know if you watched till the end, big props to you, because it might not... Like, there were some turns where they were taking forever. But I paused it a little bit, so it was still 51 minutes though. Like, if I didn't pause it, it would have been like an hour. Thank you guys for watching, and will the BBC Kings come back from this and make it 4-4 in the next game? I hope I'm gonna be able to catch it, like I said, and we will find out. OUPL Finals, it's pretty interesting, not gonna lie, even though the World Cup hype is like pretty much what is gonna take over soon, or like it already has taken over. Some people don't really care about OUPL anymore, but yeah, I'm glad that OUPL is like kind of short and will end soon, because like if it was still going and at the same time that World Cup would be going, that would be annoying as fuck to record all those games, and no one would really watch OUPL, I think, when World Cup was at the same time. But yeah, they planned it so that it would end when World Cup is around the corner, which is like kind of cool from them. Thank you guys for watching, and Dockridge signing out.